If you're using NX 3D CAD software and want to find interferences between moving parts or create flashy presentations or assembly instructions, you've come to the right place. I'll teach you how to animate in minutes. Well, gas prices are going through the roof. What better time to look at this supercharged V8 engine? Let's take a look at this gas-guzzling engine. All right, here's the V8 engine I am looking to animate. It's a fairly complete design, but there are things like piston rings and wrist pins that are missing, so you will see some parts that aren't there that should be. First thing I want to do, let's look at the inside. So I am going to start hiding things like the oil pan, transmission blower instrument panel, scoop, water pump, maybe the intake manifold as well, valve covers, headers, and maybe a few other things like the heads as well, that we can kind of focus on exactly what we're looking at here. Okay, now that we've got that done, let's hide a few more things. I'm going to highlight the wires, hit Control B, and that will highlight or hide a few more things for me. All right, so if you take a look at the inside, you can see that we don't have a wrist pin in there. We don't have some journal bearings, but hey, this thing is going to look really neat when we're animating it. All right, so step number one is I am going to start creating some rigid groups. First is going to be this block and maybe these valve journals up here. Not that we really need them, but it just looks good to have everything kind of locked down that I think is going to be fixed in space. Before we go any further, let me change a color option up here to rigid group color so you can see exactly what our rigid groups are, and you can kind of see the progress of how things are being done. Next, probably the crankshaft and its timing gear, then probably the cam and its small gear for the distributor on the opposite side of the model. Then while we're over here, let's just get the distributor and all of its related components so we can watch our rotor rotate around. Then maybe the piston, let's grab him, make a rigid group out of that. And last but not least, of course, we're going to need the connecting rod and the related components. That just might be all I need to do. Let's go ahead and get the valve train while we're at it. So the lifter, push rod, rocker, valve, but I don't want them to be one rigid group. I want to create a rigid group per object. So we'll go ahead and hit that option and it will create everything for us in a nice color. So I know exactly what I've got. When I look at my navigator, I can see everything in my list on what is a rigid group and what can and what can't move. All right, now that we've got that done, let's go ahead and add some joints. And we are going to add a fixed joint to my block, of course. We're going to add a revolute joint to the crankshaft, as you would probably have already guessed. And we're just going to pick any axis of rotation along that crankshaft is going to be fine. Same deal for the crankshaft or the camshaft. We'll just rotate it about the block along any one of these sort of fixed journals. And what else is a revolute joint? Probably the rocker. It's going to rotate around that fixed joint or that fixed component. And I think that is going to probably do it for the revolutes, except for the distributor. Let's go ahead and grab him while we're at it. And I think that's going to be all of our revolute joints. If you want to kind of see what this thing is going to look like, we'll go ahead and use our infamous move rigid group command and just spin the crankshaft around. You can kind of see how it's going to rotate. I did miss a few revolute joints on the connecting rods. Let's go ahead and add those before I pick a different joint type. Pretty simple to do. The input bodies and the axis of rotation, and that's really all you got to do. And of course, one for the wrist pin. I think that will probably cover our piston, except for, of course, we want this thing to bounce up and down. So what joint type do you think that would be? If you guessed a slider, you guessed right. And we'll simply pick its cylinder for it to bounce up and down. Same thing for the lifter. It is going to go up and down. And we'll pick the fixed block for its point of reference. And one last one for our lifter, and I think that's going to do it for all of our sliding joints. And I think that is probably going to be good enough. And we're going to worry about putting the couplers on here later, but I really want to see this piston bounce up and down. So let's go ahead and grab our crankshaft, and let's rotate it around. and see our piston go up and down as I would have expected. Like I said, I'm not going to do all seven or all eight of these things. We'll just do one, and I'll show you what the after creation process looks like. All right, now I want to get the cam rotating. So there is a gear joint for that. This is actually called a coupler. What a coupler does is it transfers motion from one joint to another. So all I need to do is pick those joints, enter the gear ratio. I think it's 0.5. And let's just go ahead and spin around. I'm not sure if I got the direction right, but a quick double check with our move rigid group will let us know. And I think I've got it right with the actual right ratio. Now that we have all our joints defined, let's add some motors. This particular product has two types of motors, a continuous motor for something like a fan, or an intermittent motor for something like a servo. I'm going to add an intermittent motor here because I don't want this thing continuously running. Could you imagine my gas bill? All right, let's add a position motor. Position motors get added to joints. You can either add a position motor or a continuous motor to a linear joint, a cylindrical joint, or a revolve joint. And I'm going to add it to this revolute joint, and we'll spin this for about 6 seconds. And, the angle. I don't know the angle. This software is smart enough to know that you can tell me that you want to calculate the end time, the speed, or the angle, and it will figure everything else out based off of duration, start time, and end time, and things like that. I know the speed. I don't know the angle, and I don't really care what the angle is, but I just know I want this thing to go around at a couple of hundred RPMs. So once that is done, we can hit the play button, and it's going to spin our crankshaft around. It's going to spin our cam around, and of course, the piston is going to bounce up and down. Sometimes I can look at this all day long. All right, now let's get the, so a gear joint transfers motion from one revolute joint to another. What do you think we'll use to transfer motion to the cam? Well, if you guess mechanical cam, you're right. So this operation here transfers motion from a revolute joint and faces on the body for that revolute joint to the actual lifter mechanism. And the face of that lifter mechanism is going to be this spherical face at the very bottom of that model. Now when we hit the go button, you'll see the lifter actually bounce up and down. Last but not least, we've got to add some motion to our push rod and lifter. And to do that, I'm going to use an infamous ball joint. So let's go ahead and add a new joint, and we'll pick a spherical joint. And I'm going to simply pick our two input bodies, and I'm going to get that little teeny face that's in there, the endpoint of that. Now, it's kind of hard to pick, so I'm going to go and change the view mode to probably wireframe and pick that very small face that's in there, hit apply, and I'm going to go do the same to the very top of our model. So we're going to pick the rocker, the push rod, and that small face that's shown there. Last but not least, on the other side of our model where our lifter is. You know the drill, rocker, lifter, pick the face, and of course we'll change our style back to shaded. Now when I hit the go button, we should see the whole valve train actually animate. If I did it right, and we did it right. Now we could speed this up, we could put an acceleration on here to kind of simulate the engine speeding up and slowing down. Last but not least, let's not forget the distributor over here. Let's give him some love. We're going to add a gear joint between these two revolute joints, one here and one up there, and this ratio happens to be a 1. So when we hit the play button, you'll see not only the piston go up and down, but the lifters, but our rotor is spinning around as well. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video and finish everything up and show you the aftermath. Now that that's done, you can see all the pistons bouncing up and down, all the lifters following their cam profile, and then the valves opening and closing like you would expect them to do. Of course, our Mr. Rotor is spinning around as well. Pretty neat animation now that it's all complete.
Well, that covers this week's lesson. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up. If you have a tip to share, leave a comment so my subs can learn more. Thanks for watching.